Yo, King Erna coming to you guys live and direct. First and foremost, go to KingErnestCMOSGold.com. That's KingErnestCMOSGold.com. The only spot to get that 64 for only $45. We in the streets of Philadelphia, Delaware, New York, New Jersey, Maryland, Baltimore, D.C., wherever we at, it's a half a man if we're on a track doing it. You hear me? Now, at the end of the day, I want you guys to understand. King Erna's having himself a beautiful time. You know, I'm just like, I love that. I love this. Listen to me. I can take this and put, youngins, you got a brand? Get this. You can put this on the moon if you want to. You and the moon can actually be there. You can put it there and get your honor intact. Now, I want to say this to everybody. I'm sick of hearing the, oh, well, you know what I mean? I already was telling her whatever, but you know, put food on my table. I'm trying to get a dollar, this, that, and the third. But homeboy, do you use that same example of a rapist or a pervert? You don't. If a rapist or a pervert, you know, came out and you didn't know they was a racist and pervert and he was a friend of yours, and it came out and it was dishonorable, you're like, yo, dog, you don't want that person to continue to be around you. So why would you have a rat around you? Why would you have an individual that is seeking to get you out of here, that don't have a problem with getting somebody else out of here? Now, I heard the whole thing with individuals saying, yeah, no, so-and-so got booked. He ain't tell on me. He, you know, I was still out here and all that. What that make? That don't make that kid a sturdy individual still. That makes you should be a Kirk Franklin somehow, Imam Shabim or somebody, because at the end of the day, alhamdulillah, you made it, but not every time you're going to make it. So when I deliver my messages, I'm really telling the youngest, don't be tricked by you kittens, man. I'm going to tell you, it's always a story. Let me give y'all something, young, and look, tune all the way into me. Come on up closer. When you got your little situations and your problems out on the street, right, and you think you're going to the OG, and the OG, he going squash it, mosh it. You dig what I'm saying to you? And you say, damn, I'm going to take OG word, right? Then you go ahead and you take OG word and the play is made. You sitting around like, God damn, how the play was made when I gave OG the word? And these OGs are the worst because they're really signed on to that. Listen to me. That makes no sense at all. You were in the streets before when you were a child, weren't you? Couldn't no mutt walk up to you and just tell you, you know, I don't want you to do this no more, or on my name, don't go through so-and-so that just killed so-and-so that you be with or be around. Don't go, don't deal with, you know. What? Listen to me. I don't know if you're a messenger boy or if you're trying to, you know, get in the middle of this, but whatever the case, will you please leave me alone? Don't ever say nothing to me. You're a kitten and I don't want to be down with it, because guess what? Real OG showing the action out here, how to move. You don't really got to stop. I mean, I gave up a year and a half, 2 years. I'm qualified, beyond certified, to be here. I gave up 2 years, 1 year for free, speaking to our youth in Camelot County in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. All you got to do is ask the people that's in charge there, from Front Island to North Philadelphia, all the way out to Knights, where Cato was at. King Erna is honored there. King Erna has came to speak there. And then that next year when I was getting the coin, alhamdulillah, I made sure I came with that same dignity and that same honor. But guess what? That goal was accomplished. All these children that was in my program were being accepted back into the public school system with no problem. When they heard I was in the building, the honor was there. When a youngin' coat got taken, I didn't even know his coat was the one that got taken. So when I came into there and spoke, I'm brand new. I'm killing them with the London Fog, but I'm giving them pure honor. I'm letting the staff know to a certain extent, listen, lay off of them, would you? You know what I'm saying? So at the, this is the one I was. So when a youngin' told, when a lady came to me, she said, listen to me, that youngin' that you just honored, we're not going to say what I honored him with. We're not looking for the gratifications. But she said, that's the kid whose coat was taken. The staff was on him saying that he wasn't listening. And I asked him what I was saying. They thought he was due to one that finding. He just had something on his mind. But he was the only one outside of like two other people and a little girl, the little girls who was in there. that was like really tuned in. You'd be surprised of the one that you think can't be fixed because you're upset and mad at that person because what? That person isn't doing what you would like for them to do right away. Well, you didn't either. You took your time to somebody, and guess what? I'm here to grab all the youngins like this. You know, I usually snatch honor, but let's do an honorable hug here. That hug is with honor, with strength, with respect. I love y'all, but at the same time, stop getting yourself out of the way. And then soon as something happened, y'all signing off guilty, pleading out to a homicide that you know that you're supposed to want to trial, life or death, that they're not killing nobody in Pennsylvania. It's not a state that's gonna allow that type of behavior because they know 95% of them people back there on death row are innocent. Free Skag Murphy, free Aaron Jones, free little Donnie, free all of these men whose strength was so big that they had to put them in isolation. And they still, for 40 years, day for day, kept their honor intact. Not gay, not weird, not strange, none of that. They are 100% men. And I'm here to stand with them based off of honor. I am the voice for the people that have honor. Am I or am I not? Am I the one that restored the honor amongst the people with no type of cockiness, with all humbleness? Yes, because guess what? There's a certain love for the people that were down. I mean, I'm not a Christian, but isn't it said that Isa alayhi salam said that he was married to who? The backslider? The one who continuously to do the wrong things and call on God or law, that one is of honor. And even Isa said he honored them. And we honor Isa and love Isa as a prophet, just like we love and honor all the other prophets. I'm King Gurner from the Honor Your Life campaign. I'm praying that the youngins got a message. I'm praying that the brothers that see me in the streets and they be like, damn, they don't be expecting me to see it and how I'm carrying it. Like a brother jump on a subway and then walk through a neighborhood to go downtown or whatever the case may be. Because you know why? The love is there. Ain't nothing like that love. Make sure y'all tune all the way in. Make sure I told all the fathers already in previous videos, get your own damn blender and walk around the house eating your goddamn CMOS gold, because at the end of the day, you don't want the kids in yours, nobody's, and when you make the customers theirs, if you're hustling off of it, you want to make sure that they get theirs honorably. King Gurner, live and direct. How much honor can one have? There's extreme, unlimited answer when it comes down to this, because it restores so much mentally and physically. I remember one time I was so quick to react on something nutty. But I got this in my life, and guess what? Honor is definitely the action to loyalty. Let's not talk about being positive. Let's be it. Live and direct. Oh, yeah, positive. Let me give y'all something. We know in a few days it's going to be the Thanksgiving thing or whatever. Stop giving these people turkeys and things of this nature. Well, you know damn well these people don't got no way to store this food. They out in the streets. Why would you give them that? Bring them into some type of diner, or you want to do something to impress me? Because you know some of them may law forgive me because I'm not cracking a joke. Some of them might have bed bugs and stuff like that. You want to impress me? Bring them in your house and feed them. That's what the people of those type of time, like that type of time, like the Isa alayhi salam, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, they brought you in your crib to eat if you was a homeless person. Umar radiallahu anhu, you remember he spoke about the homeless person and he said that man has to leave because he ate from more than three of his stomach, from more than three portions of his stomach. You know, he got to leave. Like, that's not of honor to be greedy. But bring him into your home and then King Gurner honor it. King Gurner live and direct.